In this video, we're solving a projectile motion problem that's concerned with the maximum height of a projectile, and then kind of an unusual question asking us to find the velocity at the moment of the maximum height. And by that, I mean the actual velocity vector, so speed and direction. And we're going to start this thing off by just decomposing our launch velocity into components. And that x component's going to be a 125 cosine 40, giving us about 95.8 meters per second. And then the y velocity, that's a 125 sine of 40. And that gives us about 80.3 meters per second. Now looking at part A, I'm asked to find the maximum height for the projectile. And the quickest way to do this is to use the time independent kinematics formula for the vertical motion. So I have Vy squared is V naught y squared. And then this kinematics formula has a plus 2 times A times y minus y naught, but the acceleration in this case is negative g. So I have minus 2g times y minus y naught. And the key physical point about maximum height is that Vy is equal to 0 there. This is the transition between going up and going down. So Vy must momentarily be 0 at that transition point. And then if I look at the rest of the variables I have here, I have my initial y velocity, I have g, which I know, I have my initial y position, where I would normally say that's 0 by placing my origin at the point of the launch. And then the only unknown that's left here is what's the y coordinate when the y velocity is 0, and that's the maximum height I'm looking for. So I plug things in. My initial y velocity is 80.3, g is approximately 9.8, my initial y coordinate is 0, and my unknown value of y is the only thing remaining. So this can be done all at once in a calculator. What I normally do is just imagine moving the term with the minus sign over to the left, so I only have to think about positive numbers. And then y would be 80.3 squared divided by twice 9.8. Into 3 sig figs, this gives me 329 meters for the maximum height. So now I want the velocity at the maximum height. And this is really just a concept question at this point. If the y component of the velocity is 0 at that moment in time, then all I have remaining is the x component of the velocity. And in projectile motion, that never changes. Vx is always equal to the original value of the x velocity. And so my speed at the top of this trajectory is going to be 95.8 meters per second. That was the unchanging magnitude of the x component of the velocity. And so I could say that the velocity at the maximum height is 95.8 meters per second pointing to the right. Or if you want to get really formal about it, I could call it 95.8 meters per second times I hat, the rightward pointing unit vector. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.